tap because it makes cool sounds and it's really fun.
I like tap because you get to let loose.
Tap dance is commonly known as a dance performed wearing shoes fitted with metal taps characterized by rhythmical tapping of the toes and heels.
Tap originated in the United States through the fusion of several ethnic percussive dances, mostly African tribal dances, but also Irish, English, and Scottish clog dances.
There are two major styles of tap, Broadway tap and rhythmic tap, which will be featured in this documentary.
Tap originated with the rise of minstrel shows from the mid to late 1800s, peaking from 1850 to 1870. Minstrel shows included talent competitions where people would present a variety of talents, tap being the most popular skill.
During this time, tap was solely a form of entertainment. Dancers learned and progressed by watching and learning from each other's techniques and rhythmic innovations. No tap schools existed.
Tap began to rise in popularity in nightclubs, musicals, and vaudeville shows.
The popularity of the minstrel shows later developed into the vaudeville era, where variety shows were performed on a larger scale. From the 1880s to the early 1930s, tap was showcased in vaudeville shows.
Judy Garland and Gene Kelly demonstrate tap dancing during the vaudeville era in the video called Ball in the Jack, filmed in 1932.
First approach to knees, close up tight, then you sway to the left, then you sway to the right. Step around the floor, kind of nice and light, then you twist around.
Vaudeville was often a comical theatrical piece, frequently combining pantomime, dialogue, dancing, and song. It was a type of stage entertainment consisting of various acts, which could include but was not limited to comedy, singing, and dancing.
Tap dancing at this time was very improvisational and there wasn't a real sense of technique, but dancers continued to shape tap dance vocabulary, and with the use of rhythmic music, performers were able to push tap to more dynamic levels.
Dancers gained the ability to syncopate to the music.
Tap moved from vaudeville entertainment to musicals, cinema, and film, ultimately leading to the overall style of Broadway tap.
Ball in the Jack.
For the next 50 years, Broadway tap continued to grow.
During the Roaring Twenties, tap was the dance of the decade. There wasn't a show that didn't feature tap dancing. If you couldn't dance, you couldn't get a job.
This is the style of tap dance that most people recognize and are more familiar with. We often categorize it as old school tap.
Stormy Weather is a performance by the Nicholas Brothers, two famous Broadway-style tap dancers. Fred Astaire once called this performance the greatest dance number ever filmed.
Dancers would challenge each other to a duel in which each attempted to top the other. The duel challenge was a major part of the tap dancers' education from the beginning, allowing them to learn from each other. It filtered into many theatrical acts such as the Nicholas Brothers.
Dancers continue to create their own versions of tap, so old school tap has many different names and styles within. It makes it difficult to distinguish the different styles because so many tap dancers had different qualities and approaches to rhythmic footwork. Two other famous tappers of the Broadway genre were Fred Astaire and Bill Bojangles Robinson. Both demonstrate two different qualities of tap dancing. Fred Astaire was known for his elegant dancing.
And Bill Robinson was known as the first black tap dancer to break through the Broadway color line. International Tap Dance Day, which is May 25th, is also Bill Robinson's birthday. After 50 years of Broadway tap, the art form began to change drastically. Tap decreased in popularity between 1950 and 1970 due to the rise of rock and roll music and the decline in jazz music.
Tap dancers began to move only with their feet and remove the use of arms and hands. This particular style of rhythmic tap is called hoofing and involves making louder and more prominent tap sounds while remaining more grounded to the floor. Rhythmic tap is very improvisational but can be choreographed.
The difference between hoofing and Broadway tap, hoofing has a lot more rhythmic quality to it. It's almost the drum. Like it results from the drum. When you think of hoofing, it starts from the drum. So a lot of hoofers love rhythm. They love beats. I love drums. And so that's where it really rooted from. Broadway tap is more of a showy type tap where you use more of your body and everything.
Savion Glover is a well-known living hoofer who helped bring tap dance into mainstream media by choreographing and dancing for the major motion picture Happy Feet, a film about a tap dancing penguin.
Story and a great message as well.
For all our sakes, you must stop this freaking us with the feet.
I'm best expressed through the feet, just like Mumble.
We wanted his very distinct style to sort of mark Mumble out as an individual and as an artist in himself. I mean, Savion's an artist, and in his own way, Mumble is an artist.
Sean and John Scott are two tapping twins who started tapping at the age of 6. By the age of 14, they were tapping on the sidewalks of the Santa Monica Pier. They would tap on pieces of plywood and a bucket to enhance the tap sound.
As professional modern day rhythmic tappers, they have performed with Beyonce, Usher, Prince, and Christina Aguilera. They were also on America's Got Talent and currently dance in Las Vegas.
During their youth, hip-hop dance was trending, so a lot of their movement is influenced by hip-hop. They were inspired by Sammy Davis Jr. and the Nicklaus Brothers.
There are many different styles and forms of tap dance, making it a very versatile art form.
Tap has developed over the last 1.5 centuries, moving from Broadway tap to rhythmical tap.
But today, people practice all styles of tap.
There is always a style for everyone, and you can tap at any age. It is never too late to put on a pair of taps.